Ian,
you want to go?
Sure.
Hey. Are Asmir Begovic and Branislav Ivanovic in your squad for this match? Will they train with you today?
Until now, yes. Yes. And then I will, we'll have the training session. And after training session, I'll see about this.
You said at the weekend that Branislav Ivanovic had a decision to make, a decision for him, a decision for his family. Has he not made that decision yet?
Honestly, I didn't speak with the player about this decision. And for sure, we know that he's in talking with other club, but until now I don't know nothing, and we have to wait.
Do you think there is a chance it could be done today? He could leave today?
But this question, I think it's better to do this question to the player. Yeah. Until now, not.
He's been here a long time, many years. Have Chelsea had the best of him as a player?
About Hazard?
Ivanovic, yes. Yeah. Has he had the best moments of his career here in Chelsea?
Now, for Ivanovic? Mm-hmm. But I think Ivan... he played a lot of games for this club. And he won a lot for this club. And he's 32, and I think... He can play for many years, and is able to continue his career in the right way and top level, yes. But it's important also to respect the decision of the player. Above all, if this type of player are legend in the club, and arrive a moment that if you are not playing a lot, you can decide to make another decision and to go in another team. But I have great respect for him, for this type of player.
Are you sorry to see him go?
For sure, because when you start the season to work with a squad, with a group of players, and for sure, you try to you create a link between the players and I, my staff, and for sure we are sorry if someone decided to go away, no? And the same for Oscar, for example, and also for Mikel, and but we know this is football. And we are prepared for every situation.
I know at the weekend you said that you were no closer to getting a replacement that would allow Asmir Begovic to leave. Has that changed?
Until now, I haven't news about Asmir. I think that we have to wait tomorrow, and we'll see the situation. But the situation is the same, and Asmir wants to go to play, because he wants to play every game. But also Asmir knows really well our situation, and if we are able to find a good replace, he'll go. Otherwise, he stay with us and help us to fight until the end for with the other teams to fight to win the title, to find a place in Champions.
Are you a bit frustrated that it seems to be taking quite some time to get this sorted? Would you like it clear up?
No. But I'm the football for many years, and I know these situations, and also I'm used to this type of situation before as a footballer, as player, and now as manager, and yeah, we know this type of situation, and I repeat, I have great respect for every player, because also if I can help my player to be happy, I try to do this. But it's important that the situation don't penalize the team.
Do you want to get players in before the deadline? How optimistic are you that that could happen between now and Tuesday evening?
No. I don't know. I don't know what happened. But for sure, tomorrow at 11 o'clock the night, finish this transfer window, and we'll see the new situation. The situation is normal, and I'm very calm.
How do you feel about the deadline finishing on a night when there are Premier League matches?
It's very strange. Yeah, it's very strange. It's very strange to finish after our game. It's very strange to finish the transfer window before the a tough game against Liverpool. This is not the question.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, but there is a date, 31 in January, and and tomorrow we'll play against Liverpool. But it's very strange, yeah.
You're 10 points clear of Liverpool at the moment, 8 points in front of Arsenal. You played both those clubs in 5 days. Just how significant could those two matches be in Chelsea's season?
Yeah, and this week we'll face the two great opponents, and tomorrow against Liverpool it'll be a very tough game. We'll know this above all because they came after 3 defeats, and we must pay great attention because Liverpool is a really good team. And he's in the 6 teams that can fight until the end for to win the title or to find a place in Champions League. It's a week very important, but also I know that after 2 these games, we have to play 14 games to finish the championship. And for this reason, it's important the result, but doesn't finish the league after these 2 games.
Liverpool won at Stamford Bridge earlier in the season. Do you think they are a different team, a different prospect now from when you met them earlier?
Honestly, I think that we are a different team, not Liverpool.
In what way are Chelsea a different team?
Yeah, I think that we grew a lot. If you think the first game against Liverpool, and after the game, I told that we faced a great team, a really great team, Liverpool. But today, we are not a team. Only through the work we can improve to become a team. And I think it happened. Because after the game against Liverpool and then Arsenal, we improved a lot our performance, our identity, our confidence. We grew a lot, and for this reason now we are top on the table. It's incredible, this, because it's not easy. It's not easy to to have two defeats against Liverpool and Arsenal, and to find the strength to start and to arrive atop the table and to have 13 wins in a row. But it happened, and I'm pleased for my players because they deserve this.
So how do you explain Liverpool's disappointing results over recent weeks?
It's very difficult to explain this, also because I watched very well the games that they did the defeat. I think in these games they were lucky, and tomorrow for us is a really good test, a really tough test against a tough team. Yeah, but for me, Liverpool is a really good team and good coach, good players, and they have a good experience to fight for the best, for the title. And tomorrow, I'm sure it will be a really tough game.
Nizar?
I just wanted to ask you, if you win tomorrow, do you think that Liverpool's title hopes are completely over? That's too much of a gap for Liverpool to catch up Chelsea.
Yeah, you know that I don't like to reply in the question that start if, but I think that after this game, and there are 15 games, there are a lot of points. For sure, could be an hard hit mentally for them. But I repeat, there are 15 games after this, and there are 45 points before finish the season. And for this reason, I think that the result is important, but the result doesn't decide the season of Chelsea or Liverpool tomorrow.
Liam.
Antonio, after the losses to Liverpool and Arsenal in September, you were in a tough spot, and then you had to look at yourselves as a team and change things around tactically. Are these two games also an opportunity for you now to turn the tables on some of your title rivals, and maybe with Liverpool struggling in recent weeks results-wise, put them in a position where they have to sort of reevaluate what they're doing, maybe start to doubt themselves?
It's a very long question.
It's a long, it's a long question. It's a long question. The position you were in after Arsenal and Liverpool,
yeah,
you had to change.
Yeah.
If you win against Liverpool, do you think they have to start thinking about changing?
I hope not. I hope to keep the same position, above all because tomorrow it's important for us to give continuity and to have a good result, because we'll play against one of the six teams that for me can fight for the title, and it's important for us to continue to give continuity and to try to take 3 points. But for sure, it's not easy. It's not easy. And then, I hope to change the result. If you compare the first game and the first part of the season, yeah, for sure.
Simon,
Antonio, do the players have a point to prove against the top teams? I know you've beaten a few of them, but your three defeats have been against Liverpool, Arsenal, and Tottenham. And if you lose to Liverpool again, there'll be a question mark about how good this team is against the best sides.
Do you think your players think they have a big point to make against the top teams because they've lost to some of the top teams already? Is it more important for your players to win against the top team now to make a statement?
Yeah. This type of games are always important to win, because when you have when you face teams of your same level, it's important to win, above all for the confidence. For sure the difficulty is high when you face this type of opponent. But for sure it's important. It's important to beat, to win this type of game, because increase your confidence, take 3 points the rival, and it's very important this.
The game against Tottenham, it seemed that Chelsea were a bit more defensive than normal, that it was almost like a game that Tottenham had to win and they wanted it more than Chelsea, that you were almost settling for a point. Is it important tomorrow night that you actually try and win the game, not in a similar situation, Liverpool have to win it, but it's important that Chelsea sort of also show they want to win, so
I think that against Tottenham, the game was balanced and not too defensive or a tactical defensive in our idea. No, and I don't want this. I want my player, I want my team to try every game to fight to win, and also to make the best decision to put the players more adapt for this type of games. But tomorrow I think Liverpool and Chelsea wants to win the game, and we could see an open game, not a tactical game.
Matt.
Antonio, we can guess almost your lineup, and we know how Chelsea are going to play. Why are teams finding it so difficult to beat Chelsea?
He's
saying that everybody knows how Chelsea is going to play.
Yeah.
They know the system.
Yeah.
So why are teams finding it difficult when they know how you're going to play?
Yeah, but also Liverpool has an own identity. And they played with the 4-3-3. Arsenal the same. I think that there are teams that they have an own identity and they continue to play with the same system. Other teams prefer to change the system, and usually when you change a lot your system, you lose your identity. I think this. It's better for the opponent to know your system and to prepare better. But I think that when you work in one system, and you have more time to improve your system, to find every day a different solution to improve your system. Yeah, but I think that also Liverpool, Arsenal, to big team, but also I think United. Yeah, but United change 4-3-3, 4-2-3-1, but I think this is a good thing, not a bad thing.
And is any fitness trouble for tomorrow? Any team news? Any back injuries?
No. Until now, no. And I hope after the training session to have this situation.
Okay, cameras off then, please. We'll move to